Back here on GoSoutheast.com, joined by head coach of the Southeast Missouri Redhawk volleyball team, Julie Folliard. And coach, we're outside Hauk Fieldhouse, and a place you're not going to be seeing for a while. Open up the season on Friday, 16 games on the road for about a month. How are your feelings kind of on that, and is the team ready to go?
I think we're definitely ready to go. You know, wow, 16 games in a row, I haven't heard that stat yet. So we'll definitely be resting and spending a lot of time on the bus and a lot of team bonding. But we're ready to go. We had a good preseason, a lot of hard work in the gym. Everyone's working hard and really battling for spots. So, you know, there's real no clear starting six or seven right now. It's really going to be a battle to see who's going to perform this weekend.
Now, you had a scrimmage on Sunday here at Hauk Fieldhouse. Pretty good turnout. Talk a little bit about who had good days for you.
Yeah, it was a great scrimmage. Emily led her, the white team, with 15 kills. She did a great job. We could get in system enough to get her the ball. And we really looked that to be kind of our story all year, getting her as many balls as we can, and she can really put them away whenever we can get it to her. And our outsides did well as well. They both had 13 kills, hit at a really high percentage, which is great for us, especially on the outside. It's usually they go down a little bit more with the amount of balls they get. But they did a great job, all for the white team. And then Taylor Masterson really did a great job for the black team and got her a lot of balls. She does a great job of just putting the ball where people aren't, and that gets her to score. And Carly Lurson did a great job for that team as well on the right side.
Now, you kind of know the names of the offense with the Lursons, the Coons, the Kalinowskis, but who are some of the newcomers or some of the people who maybe not have played much last year that are really going to step up and be contributors this season?
Well, I think we're going to have, you know, we have a lot of returners, and it's going to be a battle. Defensively, we played a lot of great defense. People really have a hard time putting the ball away. Even our male practice players can have a hard time with that, with the defense we've been playing. So, you know, I think Sam Lohman's done a great job defensively. Berkeley Idell's going to be in there as well, and they're really battling to get a lot of playing time in the back row and basically stopping the offense of any of our competitors.
Now, you open up at the Hawkeye Challenge this week. You start against Valpo. You also play South Dakota State, Iowa, and then you close out with Chicago State. Kind of talk about what do you know about the teams in the tournament this weekend?
It's going to be a tough tournament, but one I think we can definitely compete in. Valpo was also picked third in their conference in the Horizon, so they'll be a good contenders for us. They have a great libero coming back and some other offensive weapons, but they lost their setter, which is good for us, and we'll see how the freshman steps in and handles that position. And then we're going to go into South Dakota State, who was also picked third, tied for third in their conference. So a lot of third place preseason picks in this tournament. And they're going to definitely be tough as well. They have a lot of returners coming back. And then Iowa's, of course, going to be a big opponent. Just physically, they'll be tall and big. But I think that's a great Big Ten opponent for us to have, and one that we can realistically really challenge and hopefully get away with a big win for us. And closing out with Chicago State, I think, is a great way to end the tournament, hopefully on a high note with a win. And we'll come home with some victories.
All right, Coach. Well, thanks for your time today, and best of luck this weekend.
Thank you.